will be familiar with. This is a poem that I wrote on the night before Caroline and I got married. It's called What Belongs Together. Drum and bass, head and case, bright and early, short and curly, youth and pimple, plain and simple, far and wide, time and tide, pen and ink, kitchen and sink, tie and chin, kiss and kin, auntie and uncle, Simon and Garfunkel, touch and go, high and low, mild and mean, bubble and squeak, hands and feet, short and sweet, heart and soul, rock and roll, by and large, pole and barge, drafts and drips, fish and chips, pitch and tar, near and far, rhyming and reason, stripping and teasing, might and men, now and then, fits and starts, lonely and hard, bangers and mash, Johnny and Cash, S&M, us and them, spick and span, fry and pan, flap and tickle, women sickle, rags and riches, rasses and bitches, R&B, scones and tea, footloose and fancy free, and obviously, you. And the last one, I will just briefly give you the introduction to that. It started out, I tell my students never to do this, to interrupt themselves in the middle of a sentence and have a drink, just because that. Yeah, I'm a bit like a priest or a signpost. I know the way, I point the way, but I don't go it myself. it started out as a creative writing exercise, which was basically sort of focus on something about the person that you love, and try and find what is, you know, sort of what makes that person special in your mind, and do something with that. Now, at the time I did this, was a time when youngest son was about to be born, and my wife was diagnosed with a sarcoma on her back, which basically was life-threatening. And I realized that my greatest wish at the time was, as was hers and of course the rest of the family, that she would live to see Andrew grow up. And fortunately, the whole thing turned out to be a relative, as far as malignant tumors go, it's a pretty good one, because if it resurfaces, it resurfaces in the same place and it hasn't, thank God. But this is what came out of it. Now, what one also needs to know is that my wife has got the most beautiful head of red hair. And I remember seeing her for the first time and thinking, wow! And so this is basically what the background is for this. And that's usually what I finish off on, so I will finish off on this tonight as well. Thank you, before I do, for having been a real quality audience. It was great doing this for you. I really appreciate your, you know, braving the weather and all that. And thanks for coming. Anyway, the poem is called Caroline. Your hair, wind-blown, seems to be meshed with more silver than I'd remember. One day, we'll walk like now with the wind blowing your hair.